TBS, yes, FMG, Team Exotic, New Outlaw Order, what up, my nigga? What up? Hey, Fit, I see you. It's like nothing really matter when you broke, but some hope I bought a gallon to the gathering. Now these groupie bitches looking to score, that's how they do when they see you got a foot in the door. Yeah, they wasn't even speaking last year. I guess cause last year I had a bad year. That's when I started finding out Boom and have a friend when I was staying at my mom.
2G, aka High Definition Harold. I've been doing it, man, roughly, you know, since about 91, 92. That's when I started, man, so the... You know, the golden era, man. And as far as, like, who got me to rhyming, I got to say my brother, because he was doing it before me. And him and the homies, they used to, you know, make beats on the Casio keyboards and shit all at the crib. And I just took a liking to it. I grew up around it, so it was always around me. Yeah, no doubt, man. Mixtapes, I got, what's the first one I did? First one, Get Right or Get Left. As far as like a solo artist, I did the Get Right or Get Left mixtape. On that one, I had Philly Freeway, man, Freeway from the Rockefeller, right. And that's when rock was popping. I had Freeway on there. I think really, besides Freeway, it was really just like dudes that I was dealing with. Idol Costo. That's so fucking far back. I can't fucking remember. There was some good dudes on there, man. So definitely, y'all can check that out too. It's all over, man. But the Get Right or Get Left. Then I put out one called GWOP, you know what I'm saying? GWOP, stand for Get Wealthy on Purpose. I did that. Then I hit him with the Heart of the City Volume 1. Heart of the City. Then I hit him with the Heart of the City 2.0. That was the last one I did. But as far as like other artists, man, production for Moss. Moss do a lot of stuff for a lot of industry people. The Reza Brothers, you know, they did some stuff for Obie Trice. And it's just a gang of other people. Genocide, young kid out in South Carolina. Bodie James, I got him on a joint. The Clinic. It's a lot of people. The Black Syndicate, man. Shout out to everybody over there, too, because they're all over that thing, too, man. So, like I was saying, got people from Carolina on there, Toronto, New York, Detroit. I try to give it a good message. You know what I'm saying? I know I can't upset her. I'm feeling preaching my caller, feeling like Mason Becker. Take a peek in my life, see who I'm speaking well, for. I linked up with Vague, you know what I'm saying? I linked up with him first. And how me and Vague linked up, you know, and I'm going to talk about this a little later, but as far as like with the D-Boy Radio, you know, I was always a fan of Ollie Vegas. It's because, you know, people don't, you know, they don't know Ollie Vegas. He was like the youngest dude to ever sign a recording contract. He signed his first deal at 13 years old. And he was on the same label with 50 Cent. And this was before 50 got shot, you know, when he was over there on Columbia Records, which Tone and Polk, Trackmasters, who took both of them over there and got both of them a deal. But I linked up with him anyway. I was a fan of his, and I remember reaching out to him, you know what I mean? I'm like, yo, Vague, man, I've been a fan of yours. I rhyme, man. Why don't you come on the show and do an interview? And Vague was like, no doubt, man, let's get it done. And, you know, we just had talked that whole week. We built, you know, we got the build. So he was like, yeah, Boom, I got something. I'm starting up a new crew, man, a new group called, you know, the Black Syndicate, man. Like, I want you down with it, man. I like your rhymes. Yeah, that's what the TBS stand for. So I'm like, that, man, let's get it done. And, you know, we just start working on music, man. You know what I'm saying? And it's been, you know, inseparable, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to my bro, you know, Ollie Vegas. Shout out to A-Dash, Novi, Jetlag, Stacks, man, J-Stacks, you know what I mean? Who else we got? Ava De Nera, J-Hood, man, everybody's dope. And, like, I'm the only one from Detroit that's in the group. Everybody else is from uptown New York, so shout out to New York, too. That's my...
What about FMG?
FMG? Same kind of thing, man. And, like, you know, FMG, that's, like, that's always going to hold a special place in my heart, because... Like with FMG, man, you know, Unc Mont, shout out to him. Me and Mont, we linked up to the same thing. Mont was just coming home from doing the federal bid because, you know, he had got, you know, caught up in the stuff with, you know, the real Rick. So he was just coming home after doing, I'm sure, 11 years. And, you know, he was getting the label started. And he was just seeing me grinding on Twitter. And he just reached out to me like, yo, man, like, I see your hustle. I see your grind. You know what I'm saying? I got this label, FMG. It's popping with it. You know what I'm saying? I want you to help with some things. You know what I'm saying? My uncles, they go Rick Ross and, you know, things of that nature. And I'm like, word? He's like, yeah, man. You know, bring him on your show. I brought Rick on the show. Me and Mont, we was talking. Some days, me and Mont, we'd be on the phone 2-3 hours a day just building and getting to know each other to the point where when I moved to L.A., that's who I moved with. Like, I stayed with him, his wife, his daughter, his kids. Like, so, you know, all of them, they mean a lot to me, man. So, shout out to him. And then,
immediate family. family.
Yeah, they're definitely like immediate family. And with Rick, you know, by that being his, you know, his uncle, you know, Rick, you know, he took us all in too, because Rick was really just the face of the label, you know what I'm saying? But as far as anything, it was mine, you know what I mean? And it was really with me. I put a mixtape out and I just worked with the artists. I never was like exclusively signed to them. We were just doing business, but it's still always FMG. I am FMG, and you know, it is what it is.
What does FMG say?
Freeway Music Group. We got Freeway Music Group. So it's still popping, man. Shout out to everybody over there too. For my man Leno, you got Nonsense, Franco the God, KO. Just shout out to all of them, man. They some real talented artists. I keep it 1,000. So with Rick, you know, it was kind of like a split, you know, between the FMG and, you know, Rick got a new label now. He got anything to do with Freeway Music Group. He got the RMG, which is Rick Ross Music Group. So, you know, some things had happened, some things behind the scene. I don't want to go off too far off into that, but some things happened, whatever, whatnot. When these things happen, you know, it was like, as far as the artists who was dealing with Rick or my, you know what I'm saying, it was like we all had a decision to make. Either we gonna roll with Rick, either me, my loyalty is not gonna introduce me to him. That's no knock to Rick, you know what I'm saying, but I'm not gonna just run with him just because of his name, you know what I'm saying. This dude here brought me into his home, like I was speaking earlier, brought me into his home, so I'm like, man, I gotta roll with mine. And it was a rapper dude, man, that, you know, Rick was dealing with at the time. I don't know to what extent, but I had put a record out about dude, and that really kind of killed me, you know. And I don't think Rick took too much of a liking to it or whatever the case, like, because Rick ain't the type of dude to be mad at you, but I just think for whatever reason he didn't too much care for me doing that. So I'm sure we still cool, but I haven't spoke to Rick in a little bit over a year now. But, you know, salute to him, man. I'm happy. I see he dropped the book, man. If y'all ain't got his book, go out, grab his book, man. And I know he got the movie finna drop. And he got something. I think The Crack in the System, man, is actually out now, man. So, you know, I wish him the best, man. We just had to agree to disagree. Hey, man, I'm excited about it, man. Team Exotic, man. I be talking shit, man. Yeah, man. Y'all excuse me, man. Let it shine a little bit. So y'all make sure y'all get that, man. Yeah, Team Exotic, man. Y'all see, man, I'm getting a little emotional here. No, but nah, as far as like with the Team Exotic, man, I had an idea probably about 5 or 6 years ago, man, because like when people see me, and they might see me out with a chick, or not the whole girl, man. It's whatever, man. She's good. People are like, man, boom, you always like these mixed chicks, man. What's up with that? I'm like, man, I like exotic women. You know what I mean? So I decided, I'm like, man, you know what? I'm gonna come out with a clothing line, man, called Team Exotic, man. I just wanna see a bunch of pretty women rocking my gear, man. So I bought it to Manifestation, you know what I'm saying, about a year ago. I went out and I purchased all of the machines to kind of like make my own clothes, you know what I'm saying? I started making t-shirts and, you know, little stuff like that, and just start, you know, giving it away free. As I'm giving the stuff away, you know, people start picking up on it. Like, yo, boy, that shit dope. You need to really push it. So I'm like, man, you're right. So I'm still, you know, I let it die down for a minute because I was off into doing some other things, you know what I'm saying? So I'm really just bringing it back out again. So now I got these on deck, you know, the jackets. I got shirts that I haven't revealed yet. So it's just going to be a lot of stuff that they're going to see, you know what I'm saying, within the, you know, the next couple of months with that, man. And I did a photo shoot. I did a photo shoot about last summer, actually. I did a photo shoot and I got these kids, you know what I'm saying. Shout out to all the kids, man, who did it. JoJo, Jordan, see you. Man, that's my homegirl, man. She came out, man. She did a beautiful job, man. That's like, you know, Team Exotic model, man. So shout out to her, man. But yeah, man, Team Exotic, man, the website will be back up in a minute. Y'all make sure y'all check for that, man. It's a great thing. Man, but first, man, LA is huge. So by LA, like, being so big, man, when I first got down there, it was just, I'm just looking at shit and I'm seeing palm trees. This shit is crazy. But by my being from LA, when I moved there, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, shout out to everybody down there, man. A-Tray Gangsters, you know what I'm saying? That's not me promoting gangs or nothing like that. But, you know, by them, you know, being Crips, these are the people that, when I first got down there, that I'm around. So they was always showing Detroit love. Like, yo, man, Detroit, man, I heard y'all get it in down there. And I'm like, yeah, man, we do our thing. And it's coming from real gangbangers who still banging over flags. And I'm just like, yo, I'm a dude from Detroit. I'm just trying to make it with this rap. And, you know, dudes respected me, man. But as far as, like, just the people down there, man, it's no different, man. It's the same. A lot bigger than Detroit. But it's the same, man. As long as you carry yourself right out there, you got to know where you at all times. You know what I'm saying? You got to know where you at all times. Yeah, I'm working on a money project now, man, and it's hard, man, not to release some of the new stuff I got, but I'm gonna start releasing some stuff right after the new year, man. I'm talking in January, but I got the money project. The money, M-O-N-E-Y, not promote this acronym. This stands for Make Other Niggas Envy You. You know what I mean? So I got that, and I think what I'm gonna do with that one, I'm gonna put about, you know, 10 to 12 joints on there, all new bangers, all original joints, man. I just want people to, you know, to hear the growth and experience and just really the stuff we're talking about now, like the times in different cities, man, in these different places, and, you know, all type of shit that I picked up out here. So I got the money project, and then as far as like the album, I'm gonna put that out, it's probably second quarter, you know, when I put that out, you know what I'm saying, I ain't got that title actually, but they could be expecting that, so they're gonna get at least two projects out of it. Yeah. Life.
Jizzle me, hold you, motherfucker, told him, B-Boy Radio, y'all know the brand.
Google Boom2G, you can Google B-O-O-M space, number two letter G, and 2-G-E-E. Let me tell some people some things real quick, man. Please, man, DJs, rappers, singers, whatever. Stop spelling my name like that. Because it's not B-O-O-M space 2-G-E-E. Letter two. Number two. Letter G, man. Stop spelling my shit right. You're getting your man off the shit, man.
But anyway.
Yeah. Well, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck?
With your silly ass. For a minute, wasn't he fucking with you? That rap chick name.
Haven't got the movie face to face yet. He knows about me. I know about him. It's basically 100% official. And man, we gonna get it done, man. So shout out, man. Man, big up to Supreme, man, and the whole Lima movement, man, for plugging me in with that. Cause, you know, he didn't have to do that. Last year, this time I was in the spot waiting. Now I'm a whole man. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. I do. Man. They probably send it all on Facebook with the whole marriage shit and the rings and all that, man. And I respect her privacy. I never saw her name, but she already know what we're talking about, man. And yeah, she's a good lady, man. And she keeps me grounded. You know what I mean? Because, like, I was so used to, you know, being with women that just had this, oh, I'm fucking around with Boom2G. Not that I'm fucking Jay-Z or anybody like that, but, so these chicks would just do whatever I told them to do or shit like that. But with this one, you know what I mean? She's more like, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. If I'm right, I'm right. You know, she's not just going to agree with shit. That's just bullshit, man. So, yeah, man, shout out to her, man. You know, she's doing her thing. She's a hard worker, man. And I just want to be able to, you know, give her the things that she deserves and even more, man. So shout out to my girl. You know what I'm talking about. Love you, baby. This is what we doing, man. Salute.